Hi, I'm Stephen. Welcome to CG Films. It's currently 8:40 in the morning and I've been to Tesco's, and today it's going to be opening, and that is Far Cry 4. Woohoo! Now, as you can see, it's a limited edition because it's kind of standard, that is, because I think most places will have the limited edition than a standard one. But overall, I actually got this for £42 in Tesco's, because when I found it on the website, and basically they change it now and again for the past few weeks, and one time it was 40 and I'm like, oh, I want it for 40, but instead it's 42. Overall, I picked up Far Cry 4 because in the past I played a few Far Cry titles. Far Cry 2 was alright, and I was unsure about Far Cry 3 until my friend borrowed it from work, and I actually enjoyed Far Cry 3, and actually got that for a good price at the time, and when it was out, because some store has a really good price at the time. Overall, I decided to get Far Cry 4, and I'm looking forward to playing this, as well as a different, you know, character villain than it is in Vaz and on Far Cry 3, because Vaz was very, very good, if I pronounce his name right, because he was a great character and other types of variations. Anyways, enough of my jibber jabber, let's have a look at the artwork. As you can see, the very good artwork, except for the standard edition gets some guy holding the grenades, but instead they got this. They should do standard editions, let alone this is kind of a limited edition because they're doing loads of these at the moment. Anyways, here is the side, here's the back, as you can see right here. Tells you some information about the game, which is quite nice. And as you can see, it's nearly about 25 gigabytes worth of install, but it's actually around like 24-ish, which I found out on the Xbox store. But on that though, I'm looking forward to playing this, which is going to be great. Anyways, get stibby knife. Stab it. Take off the shrink wrap. A little bit on the end there. Anyways, we'll open her up and see what content we have inside. So here you have your limited edition thing. And as you can see by the advertisement here, it comes with this and plus a big harpoon gun and stuff like that. And it's just alright, I guess. Here you have an advertisement about the season pass, and as you can see, there's a Yeti and other types of variations, so you can see what the content has in the season pass, and plus in multiple different languages, and since this is a European copy, I'm guessing. Then plus an advertisement at the back about the statue you can get on Ubisoft phone collectible type website type thing. And finally, you have this really small black and white-ish manual. Because I don't have much of Xbox One games as a manual, but overall it's quite nice to have a really small dinky manual. And there's an advertisement on the back, some stuff about Uplay features, which is quite nice. And sadly no Uplay passport thing, because they do that in previous games, and I guess they decided to scrap that since the last Ubisoft game that actually got on Xbox One was Watch Dogs. And finally, here is the disc itself. As you can see, it's a bit more colourful-ish than the front. And as you can see, that's the man that I was talking about that was holding the grenade. Oh, I feel so sorry for him. Anyways, so that's my opening of Far Cry 4. Hope you really enjoyed this video. Anyways, I'll leave you with some gameplay. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steezy Films.
Leaders. A two-headed elephant pulling in opposite directions and going nowhere.
No! Thank you, young man. My family will...